How well do we understand facial expressions?
Emotional expressions are much more nuanced and variable than people have assumed.
And do our faces reliably express our feelings? What emotion is this person feeling? What about this one?
We can use facial expressions to communicate how we're feeling, but it can also sort of reflect different personality traits.
Is this person distraught or elated? Furious or celebratory?
The interest in facial expressions and the modern science of emotion really began in the 1960s with a scientist named Sylvan Tompkins and two of his postdoctoral fellows, Paul Ekman and Cal Izzard. They were very interested in testing the hypothesis that everyone around the world scowls when they're angry, smiles when they're happy, and correspondingly, that everyone around the world recognizes those facial movements as expressions of emotion.
These ideas stood largely unchallenged for a generation. But many researchers now believe that the picture is a lot more nuanced.
What we're dealing with is highly variable, highly context-sensitive, temporally changing patterns.
And these contexts are one of the key factors researchers are investigating as they try to understand facial expressions.
While people are moving their faces, they're also speaking, there are acoustical changes in the vocalizations, there are body postures, the person carries around with them a whole internal context of their body, and then there's the external context, you know, who else is present, what kind of situation are they in, what are they doing, and then there's a temporal context, and all of that contextual information really matters. So whereas scientists used to focus primarily on the face, now they're focusing more on faces in context.
Research into expressions has typically relied on showing subjects posed photographs of faces representing different emotions. But photographs like this are often just faces in isolation with no context at all. Also, because they are static, they lack the temporal context which could be read in a moving face. What's more, the researchers have to start by assigning emotions to expressions, which can introduce biases and subjectivity. To get around this, researchers are turning to technology to find more neutral ways of studying emotion.
The approach that we take is more of a bottom-up, objective approach.
Rachel Jack's research uses a computer which randomly generates dynamic facial expressions.
We've used this really to look at main differences between cultures in terms of the six classic emotions: happy, surprised, fear, disgust, anger, and sad. And we found that East Asian facial expressions of these emotions tends to be signalled primarily with the eye region, so the eyebrows and differences in the eyes, whereas with Westerners, the face movements tended to vary more in the mouth region. These differences also in the location of expressivity on the face is mirrored very nicely in cultural emoticons. So in Western emoticons, what you find is that there's two eyes and then the mouth tends to vary to be able to express sadness, happiness, and so on. And it's the opposite pattern with East Asian emoticons, in that the mouth is either minimized or it's completely absent, and it's the variance of the eyes which communicates different emotion messages.
Differences like this are leading some researchers to believe that expressions are not as universal as once thought, and that some behaviours might be learnt in childhood.
What's happening in early childhood is emotion knowledge is being bootstrapped into the brain, into the brain's wiring. This is also what happens when you change cultures. When you move from one culture to another culture, you have to learn, well, what is the nod of a head, or the raise of a lip, or the shake of a head? You know, what do these things actually mean in this culture?
Despite these complexities, the idea that facial expressions could be used as a way to read emotions has excited big business. Leading tech companies have already started developing algorithms to detect expressions. And one estimate suggests the industry could be worth $56 billion by 2024. Systems are already being trialed or marketed in a wide variety of fields.
For hiring purposes, in educational settings, in security settings, and in certain places, even in legal settings.
But despite the predictions, many scientists think that claims software could read emotion may be premature.
We often make facial expressions that convey an emotion message, but doesn't necessarily mean that we have this emotion inside. So oftentimes we smile out of politeness, we want to convey to the other person that, you know, they're welcome, etc. But this doesn't necessarily mean that you're experiencing an emotion. The other challenge is that it could be very easy to trick automatic facial expression detection systems. So we may want the system to believe that we are feeling sad or happy. And so it would be quite easy for a human then to create or to generate realistic facial expressions that could trick a system.